Now, we invited Secretary Duque to give his side on the COA report, but his office says there is a conflict in his schedule. Now, what explanation could be behind the undocumented spending of some 67 billion pesos worth of funds? We're going to talk to someone who has headed the department. Former Health Secretary Esperanza Cabral joins us now. Dr. Cabral, good afternoon to you, and thank you for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Carmina.
All right. I want to begin with what Secretary Duque said about the COA report. He said the 67.3 billion is accounted for and that there is no corruption. Are you buying the statement coming from Secretary Duque, Dr. Cabral?
Well, obviously, the 67 million have not been accounted for, but I hope that he can account for it. There is always the possibility of corruption, but again, I hope that there is none. We need to give the DOH a chance to explain what has happened. The COA report is really observations, and the COA actually provides the department a chance and time to explain the observations that they have made.
All right. Dr. Cabral, the secretary also said, rest assured that the funds allotted to the DOH are all spent for procurement of test kits. He goes on to say of PPEs, payment of healthcare workers, benefits and all that. Now, what do you think? Should the public take the secretary's word for it, Dr. Cabral?
On its face value, yes. I think that we should really give them a chance to explain. On the other hand, there have been many instances in the past when we have been unable to rely on the word of the secretary. So that leaves us room to doubt whatever it is he says. Still, I think that we should give him a chance to explain.
No. How difficult is it really? I mean, you've been there, you've occupied that office. How difficult is it really to account for the department's budget?
Sometimes it's easy and sometimes it's not. You need to see that this report was as of December 2020. So maybe the money that they spent in the last quarter of that year, for example, they have not been able to get the documents sufficiently, and they were not able to submit this to COA on time. And that's why that kind of observation was made. That's the reason why I said the COA actually gives them time to explain and to account for this funds that they have observed have not been fully accounted for.
But is this a manifestation of the kind of leadership that the department has?
Well, if you read the executive summary of the COA report, which I did, the COA report was voluminous. So I just really went through the executive summary. It really says there that leadership and governance are important to the way the funds are accounted for. And so they say the secretary was given this particular report and he has agreed to do this kind of thing. So it's really leadership and governance that will have to account for this.
Because you have other departments that have other departments that have performed well according to the Commission on Audit.
Yes. For example, I saw in the news that the Office of the Vice President, for example, was given the highest rating of COA. So it is possible to get good reports instead of adverse reports from the COA.
A while ago, we heard from Secretary Minardo Guevara of the Justice Department. He said that it is possible for the secretary to rectify the situation if he is able to give an acceptable explanation. Given the numbers and given the amounts that we're looking at here, Dr. Cabral, what possible acceptable explanation could there be for these undocumented spendings?
That's hard to say, but one is they were not able to get all of the receipts in order to show that they bought stuff. okay? And they have to produce this kind of receipts. Maybe somebody lost it or something like that. I don't really know. There were also observations that the proper procurement processes were not done. Maybe it's because they were in a hurry because this is an emergency procurement, but they will have to really be brought to task and asked to explain these things. And we have to keep an open mind, even though there are very many things that will cause us to doubt whether they can account for it or not, but we need to make them account for it.
That's sort of asking a very difficult thing from the public at this point, given that, as you said it yourself, there were many instances in the past, right, that would make it easier for some to doubt the secretary. So that's quite a tall order to ask them to give the secretary a chance, try to believe whatever he says. Dr. Cabral.
Yeah, I'm aware of that. Yeah, he's in a very difficult position.
Now, Dr. Cabral, there was a point in your career when the department was actually turned over to you from Secretary by Secretary Duque during his first stint as Health Secretary. What were the state of funds at that time when you took over the department from him?
Well, the funds that we accounted for were not as much as 205 billion, which was the funds for 2020 of the Department of Health. But during those times, there were a few adverse observations that we were able to correct, because I came in during the first half of the year, and that's when the reports come out. And there are a few adverse reports, again, mostly on procurement, but we were able to see where the deficiencies lay and how we were able to correct it.
So at that time, sorry to cut you there, doctor, but at that time, where were these deficiencies?
In the procurement issues.
And what happened then? This is during the time of his first stint as Health Secretary. Go ahead, Dr. Cabral.
Yes, our finance section were able to reconcile these materials.
Mm. So was it at that time just a poor record keeping?
Yes, I would think so. At that time, the bidding processes were followed. The procurement processes were followed. The distribution processes were followed. There were no complaints from the local government units that they did not receive the goods that they were supposed to receive. So they were all just a reconciliation of papers.
Mm. Is it difficult to do that so that the reconciliation doesn't happen after the fact?
Sometimes it can be. Most of the time, no.
Why?
Things can actually get lost. There are so many papers that this finance department need to look at, and sometimes they're not able to find the documents on time.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's when you look at even just the executive summary of the report, Dr. Cabral, you know, there's a whole list of items there, right, of undocumented spending. What to you is the most glaring in the COA report?
Let me see.
Because you have the purchases worth 5.038 billion. There's a lack of
right. Yeah. There. Oh, I think the most important here and the most difficult to account will be the funds that were provided to the health facilities and enhancement program, because those are infrastructure projects. So for the money that they spend, they have to show that some building went up.
Mm. And if they fail to show that?
They'll have to account for it, and people will have to be told where the money went.
Mm. And Dr. Cabral, the fact that we're discussing this and the fact that there's, you know, an observation that there is undocumented spending worth more than 67 billion, the fact that that's happening in this time of the pandemic, what does that tell you?
Well, I hate to say it, but I think our department is in over its head. I sympathize with them because this kind of pandemic has never happened before. And because we have underinvested in healthcare for the longest time, we are now reaping the results of that, not only in terms of personnel who are not ready to handle this kind of pandemic, but in the rest of the infrastructure for healthcare delivery. So we really must take this opportunity to search our souls and decide whether health is important to us or not, whether the health workers who have been there working should be compensated the way the economic managers are being compensated, for example, whether they should be trained and their capacities built in the same way that other organizations are doing that, whether they should be provided with the materials and the equipments that they need, and whether they should be provided with a kind of leader who can do all of these things.
Finally, Dr. Cabral, in a 67 billion pesos worth of undocumented spending, to some, this can represent 67 billion reasons why the secretary should vacate his post. Do you think that Secretary Duque should step down? And if he doesn't, should President Duterte still keep him?
That's up to the two of them. I think that for the past 2 years, since March or April last year, people have been calling for the president to remove Dr. Duque from his post. And so far, he has not done that. What he has done instead is to defend him. So he is the appointing authority. There is no one else accountable for the presence of Dr. Duque there except the president. So,
despite these findings, though, from an internal audit mechanism, which a lot of people were saying it works, it just shows that there is an internal audit mechanism that works in this country. Despite these observations, Dr. Cabral, and the president decides to keep the secretary as part of his cabinet, what does that tell you now?
That tells me that we should vote wisely next year.
We have to leave it at that. Dr. Esperanza Cabral, former Secretary of the Health Department, we appreciate you coming to the show. Take care. Keep safe.
Thank you, Carmina. You take care too.
Thanks. Appreciate it.